What is forest stand improvement? The ground's still not really frozen enough here at Bear Island to work in the areas that I want to work in. And I was at home kind of spinning my wheels and decided to come up here and do some non-commercial forest stand improvement. Forest stand improvement, you'll see it abbreviated as FSI, or it's also sometimes called timber stand improvement, TSI, is non-commercial forest management. So that just means that we're not producing any products. All the trees that we're cutting are actually just gonna stay here in the woods. The purpose of this non-commercial work is essentially to go into a stand that is too young or too degraded to manage commercially and to help it out, to use the tools that we have at our disposal, in this case, a chainsaw, to help it be healthier in the future. In its simplest iteration, FSI or TSI is being applied to, let's say, like a stand of pine trees that are all exactly the same age, and you're just going in there and favoring the healthiest trees by cutting less healthy trees that are competing with them, and thus alleviating them from the stressors of competition. Now, in a more diverse forest stand, like the stand of hardwoods that I'm gonna be working in, you can have an influence not just on helping the healthiest trees have more room to grow, but also on the composition of the forest. You can favor certain species of trees versus other species of trees. So in this case, I'll be favoring sugar maple versus diseased beech trees. You can also create other habitat features of significance. So you can put gaps in the canopy. Gaps in the canopy are really important for inspiring regeneration in the understory, but then also awesome foraging habitat for insectivorous birds. As you do this work, you'll also be felling trees and leaving them on the ground. So giving this young stand the benefits of having some dead wood on the ground, which is a really, really important ecological feature, benefits to forest hydrology, as well as benefits to wildlife habitat. We can be doing things like developing a more diverse understory, which is really important to invertebrates and also understory plants and all of the species that feed on those things. And you're gonna see that I'm not gonna be lopping these trees up and making them neat and tidy at all. One thing that I really wanna do is actually to create a big jumbled mess, which is gonna preclude deer's ability to browse the young trees and plants that are gonna regenerate in the understory. So besides improving the health of this stand by giving the healthiest trees more room to grow and thus to become larger and healthier and expand their crowns and all of these really positive things. The other thing that we need to be cognizant of is that the sheer volume of threats and stressors that those trees are facing right now is incredibly massive. So anything that we can do to alleviate these trees from a little bit of stress, like the stress of competing with their neighbors, can really help them deal with all these other stresses, like these storms of increasing severity, drought, inundation, non-native invasive pests, shifting disturbance regimes, shifting seasons, all of these other things that they're forced to face at once. It's a way that we can help our forests endure the many challenges that they face at this moment in time. A couple other things, all the trees I'm felling are gonna stay on the ground. I'm not gonna cut up their branches. I'm gonna drop them and just leave them there. I don't care about how high the stumps are, and actually, I'm gonna intentionally try and keep some of these trees attached to the stumps so that instead of laying on the ground, they actually stay upright, which will maintain their value for precluding deer browse and storing carbon and providing the habitats associated with dead wood in the long term. And with smaller trees, I may even do a little bit of hinge felling to keep them attached to the stump. Check it out.
Drift away. Something is where my friends won't bother me. Ooh.